And back to North Carolina for the 2022 Golf Croquet National Championships. Of the 15 or 20 clubs west of Asheville in the mountains, four have gotten together to host these nationals: Sapphire Valley, Chattooga, High Hampton, and today Hampton's Falls are putting on this tournament. We'll zoom into Hampton's Falls, and you can see they have two lawns in that bright patch there, and this is how they look on Brian Hovis's drone the day of the semifinals. The first semi between Sharif Abdulwahab and Blake Fields was held on court one, filmed from that white tent down there by Brian Hovis, and that's already up for you to look at. Today, we're finishing the semifinal between Matthew Essick and Tom Balding there on court two to the left.
This again is the USCA Golf Croquet National Championships in May of 2022. It takes a crowd to put on one of these things. The critical personnel are Jeff Sue, a tournament director, assisted by Eileen Sue and Mike Albert. Mike Albert is the tournament manager. And today's videographer is Paul Neubecker. This event and this channel are both sponsored by the United States Croquet Association, where you can get everything you need to know about this great sport of ours, whether it's golf croquet, AC, U.S. rules, or even nine wicket.
In game one of this semifinal, Matthew won the first in a near rout. Matthew made no mistakes, and Tom looked a little nervous. Game two, Tom Balding found his stroke, came back to even the score, 7-5 for one game apiece, and that's how we start today with everything all tied up in game three.
Yeah.
Tom wanted hoop 12 with the red ball. Matthew can choose which of his to play with, and he decided to start with blue. It's a small sample, but it took Tom two tries to hit blue from the boundary, so that would put his critical distance at about 20 yards, which pretty much characterizes his performance from the beginning. The first year he played AC in 2018, he was a real tactical novice, but he won all 24 games he played because he never missed anything. And now he's on the McRoberson Shield team because last fall, he won second flight in the selection eights, almost all with triple peels. He was playing for the in off and he got darn close. Matthew, of course, is a six-time national champion, all in the last 3 years, and he's the defending champion in this event. And I took their dynamic grades off the scoreboard because it doesn't matter what their dynamic grades are now.
Yeah.
Plan A is always set up first and clear second, but you have to go to plan B when you think the second ball may not be there two turns later. Mallet heads where the two ends play differently are illegal. But people do this all the time as sort of a twitch. They're both playing travel trimmers, I think. And for the curious, the hoops are quadways and they're set nominally at a 16th of an inch, which is what the rules specify with some leeway. Clearing both opponent balls in one stroke is a huge advantage. Which you lose as soon as you miss the hoop shot.
This thing's not here.
It's a fish hook.
Game one,
game two.
And who are you? Should have gotten. Okay. And how about it?
Game three.
Other time. Really? Really? Is everyone playing well?
Yeah.
It was a beatdown in the first game, but Tom found the stroke and pulled game two out.
Okay. And it's
2-1 now.
Okay. So that one could go either way.
Yeah.
This one, they should
have it. I shocked you didn't put the block down.
What?
I'm shocked they didn't put the block down.
No, no, she hits.
No, but I mean, they were together on this boundary. You could have just rolled right in front.
Yeah, good move. Let's just see if Blake gets one shot and not worry about it. For sure, Houston. Do you have a drink? For the money. Told him not to go in the jaws. We didn't listen.
This one's a little over 80 feet, but you're going to have to pretend you're listening to it on the radio.
Oh!
In croquet, the sound tells all.
Wow, that was
clearing two balls and jawsing your own is really pretty good usually. But you got to hit the right balls.
Let's go, Sharif. I like the reset. That was a good call.
I actually want to see game three, but that's okay.
There he is, the grand old man of golf croquet, still a kid at heart. And he's now the pro at Wildcat Cliffs, which I think is about 2.5 miles from here as the crow flies. Probably at least twice that by road in these mountains.
That was to Steven.
Yeah, that's my special.
I can't tell in this shot if he's trying to nudge yellow gently or clear blue gently, so red stays in position. Didn't get either one, though. I'm sure if we had a crowd of a couple hundred, that shot would have gotten a big round of applause. Thank you. Matthew's obviously jawsing blue on purpose here, and I suppose it's to suck red into getting out of position somehow. But I think he might have been better off just to make the hoop there. Now I see why he did it. The elite player's wily mandated obligation to entertain. And he is an elite player. He's trying to go through the hoop backwards to clear yellow. That's not going to give yellow much of a problem. Nice shallow approach angle makes blocking feasible. Good shot. And it gives Matthew the chance to entertain us again. The bounce was perfect. And here, blue doesn't present much of a problem because it came in from the wrong side. Two straightforward 9-10 foot hoop shot misses in a row. Matthew doesn't need that kind of help. He's obviously thinking about a rush to hoop 9. But he either changed his mind or just didn't get it.
Takes more than one person, too.
Ideally. Once the holes are set up, club members can set up.
This is tricky. Where does he put red so he doesn't give either blue or black an in off?
Help them out.
Pretty sure he's shooting it red here.
Thank you.
If you watch the other semifinal, second game, this is what Sharif thought Blake should have done to him toward the end of the game. Almost made the highlight reel. Matthew Essick, 7-4 over Tom Balding in game three to take the semifinal 2-1 and earn the right to face Sharif Abdul-Wahab in the final. Tom Balding proved he belongs at this level, and Matthew's usual world-class play prevailed. So subscribe, give us a like, hit that notification bell so you know when the final's coming out, and check out the USCA for everything croquet.